Okay, yung arrow dyan is nagre-represent ng electric field sa bawat charges. Okay? So, napapansin nyo dun sa positive charge. Yung arrow pa-outward, no? Then, yung sa negative charge naman, yung arrow pa-inward or yung direction ng electric field. Okay, so it shows the direction of the electric field of positive and negative charges. So, positively charged particle creates outward electric fields. And a negatively charged particle creates inward electric fields. Sa ano natin, no? Just sa figure na makikita niyo. Kung meron tayong test charge A, okay, yung test charge natin is always positive. The direction of an electric field is away from a positive charge and toward a negative charge. Tingnan niyo mabuti, class. Kung parehong positive yung charge, syempre, di ba? Kapag like sign or like charges, repel, and unlike charges, attracts. Tingnan niyo yung direction. Kapag positive charge, yung flow ng electric field natin is outward. Then, kapag negative charge naman, yung flow ng electric field natin ay pa-inward. Meron akong point, positive point charge, U sub 1, and small positive test charge. So, kapag alamin natin yung force between two charges, formula na force is equal to K times Q sub 1 times Q sub 2 over R squared. And this is R between charge 1 and charge 2. Kung alamin natin, class, yung magiging electric field, let's say at point Q sub 2, that is force over charge. Kung alamin natin electric field. Okay? So, yung unit sa electric field is, electric field is unit force per unit of charge. So, bakit si positive test charge ang ginagamit natin dito, class? Sa tingin nyo. Okay. So, kung mabalikan natin yung figure dito, class, ito, tandaan nyo lang na yung flow o yung direction ng ating electric field kapag sa positive charge ay pa-outward. Okay? Outward electric fields. While negative charge particle creates inward electric fields. So, dito sa class, gumagamit tayo ng positive test charge kasi kumbaga ito, yung small amount lang ng positive yung test charge na yun ay hindi makaka-apekto dapat dun sa mga ibang charges. So, for example, this one, nire-relate ko lang sa math. Kung meron ako ditong positive tsaka negative numbers. Okay, meron akong positive tsaka negative numbers. At meron akong positive dito, ito yung positive, ito yung test charge natin. Okay, kung ipag-multiply ko to positive sa negative, anong magiging result? Still, positive pa rin. Okay? Kung ipag-multiply ko naman yung positive, kung ipag-multiply ko naman yung positive sa negative, still, negative pa rin. So, dun sa dalawa, sa charge na ginagamit natin para malaman natin yung electric field at a certain test charge, ay gagamit tayo ng positive test charge dito. Okay? So, now, if we have the force, which is K times Q sub 1 times Q sub 2 over R squared per unit charge. So, that is E. Diderive natin na E is equal to K times Q sub 1 times Q sub 2 over R squared over, depende kung ano yung magiging test charge natin. Let's say, ang test charge natin ay nasa Q sub 2. This one. Ang test charge natin ay nasa Q sub 2. So, over Q sub 2. And makakancel yan. So, mapupunta to sa denominator. This one. Mapupunta naman to sa denominator, di ba? Dyan. Then, makakancel si Q sub 2. So, we have another formula for electric field is K times Q sub 1, where Q sub 1 is point charge over R squared. Okay, again, K is column constant. Yung value natin dyan ay 9 times 10 raised to 9 newton meter squared over C squared. Okay? So this one. So dun sa binigay kong figure kanina, yung positive test charge ko dyan, yung Q sub 2. A small positive test charge at location A in the preceding figure experiences a force that is in the same direction as electric fields. A small negative test charge, negative Q sub O. Ano nangyari, class? Dun sa positive test charge na Q sub O. Dun sa pangalawang figure, this one. Kung meron tayong positive test charge, ano nangyari? Hindi naman naka-apekto, di ba? Yung direction ng ating electric fields ay pa-inward. Okay? Hindi naman naka-apekto. Since positive attracts to negative. So, a small negative test charge at location B experience a weaker force since it's farther away from a central charge. So, may parang idea din siya, di ba? Since alam natin na yung distance is inversely proportional sa force before nung dun sa mga nakaraang lesson natin. So, the farther, the weaker force. Mas malapit, mas malakas yung force na ramdaman dun sa dalawang charge na yan. Then, because the force on the positive charge is in the same direction as the electric field, we always use positive test charge to determine the direction of it. So, the following set of rules provides a consistent method of drawing electric field lines. So, number one, electric field lines points in the direction of the electric field vector E at every point. Nakikita yung arrow doon, ibig sabihin niya, electric field is also vector quantity. So, it has magnitude and direction. Electric field lines start at positive charges or at infinity. Ito nabanggit ako kanina. Electric field lines end at negative charges or at infinity. Electric field lines are closer together. E has a greater magnitude. The farther, the weaker. The closer, the greater magnitude. The number of electric field lines entering or leaving a charge is proportional of the charge. And remember, class, that electric field is directly proportional to force. Okay? Since electric field is a unit of force per unit of charge. And again, electric field is also inversely proportional to distance between the test charge and the point charge. So ito na yung binabanggit kanina sa mga rules. So the rules of how these rules are applied. In the figure below, the electric field lines all start at the positive charge point radially outward and go to infinity. In addition, the lines are closer together near the charge. So yung arrow dyan na makikita nyo, class, hindi naman yan hindi yan force. Positive charge dito, na Q. So, yung arrow na makikita nyo dyan, yan yung electric field na makikita nyo. Or electric field lines. Okay? And yung direction niya is point away from positive charge. Okay? So, in the next figure shows the field produced by a charge of negative 2. The direction of the field lines is reverse. They start at infinity and end on a negative charge. Pa-inward niya, di ba? In addition, the number of lines is doubled. Of the charge has been doubled. Kung mapapansin nyo dito, class, yan, konti lang yung amount na field lines na nakapalibot dun kay positive Q. While dito, nakikita nyo naman dyan, negative 2Q. Okay? Sabi natin, kung directly proportional yung force dun sa amount o dun sa magnitude ng mga charges, so ibig sabihin, class, electric field is directly proportional din doon sa force. So kaya tingnan niyo, mas maraming arrow na nakikita niyo diyan is mas malakas yung electric field na naranasan sa bawat charges. So electric fields tends to form specific patterns depending on involved. A few such patterns for various combinations of charges are shown in the figure below. Meron tayong positive 2Q and negative Q. Okay? Mapapansin nyo yung fields, yung field lines, makikita nyo, di ba? Mas maraming field lines doon sa positive 2Q compared doon sa negative Q. Kung ba, nakadepende doon sa magnitude ng bawat charges. Magiging field lines din. No? Ito yung arrow na to class, hindi yan force, okay? Ibig sabihin yan, yan yung electric field and yung kanyang direction ng electric field. So, titingnan niyo yung class. Positive pa outward. Okay? Pa outward yung electric field niya. Then while doon sa negative charge naman ay pa inward. Okay? Then dito naman sa figure B, napansin niyo dalawang positive Q, positive charge, dalawang positive charge. Parehas pa outward yung direction ng kanilang electric field. So hindi sila pwede mag-meet. Oh, hindi sila pwede ma-attract. Okay? Tandaan nyo lang, like charges repel. Then dito naman, electric dipole, yan. Same, yung magnitude. Okay, different charge. Unlike sign, same magnitude. Positive Q, negative Q. Tingnan nyo yung, ano, tingnan nyo yung amount ng field lines na nakikita nyo dyan. Ay same lang sila. So, ito na. Electric field intensity. So, definition of the magnitude of electric field, denoted by E. If a small positive test charge, Q sub O, experiences a force of magnitude F at a given location, the magnitude of the electric field E at that location is magnitude of electric field, that is force on positive charge over amount of charge. So we have E is equal to F over Q sub O. Okay, yung units natin, newtons per coulomb. Okay, electric force due to an electric field. A charge Q in an electric field E, may arrow dyan, yung arrow sa taas ng E, ibig sabihin vector quantity, no? Experiences a force F given by a force is equal to amount of charge times electric field. So, dinerive lang kanina. Kung meron tayong electric field is equal to force over charge, so si force naman is equal to Q or charge times electric field. Amount of charge times electric field. Unit natin, SI unit para sa force ay newtons. Okay, ito na, pinakita natin yung derivation kanina. No? Ang magnitude naman of electric field due to a point charge. We have magnitude of electric field is equal to K times charge. Kunin nyo muna yung absolute value nun over R squared. Example tayo, class. Find the magnitude of the electric field produced by a 1 microcoulombs, micro yung class ha, microcoulombs point charge at a distance of 0.75 meters. What are the given class? You have point charge here is equal to 1 microcoulombs. Okay, and take note 1 microcoulomb is equal to 1 times 10 raised to negative 6. And distance R is equal to field, electric field is equal to, given natin yung charge, tsaka yung distance. So we will use K times Q over R squared. Okay, 9 times 10 raised to 9 Newton meter squared over C squared times 1 times 10 raised to negative 6 coulombs over 0.75. So, cancel yung isang C dyan. So, may matitira pang isang C, no? Pero, i-square nyo rin yung, ano, 0.75. I-square nyo pa yung 0.75 sa denominator. Makasabihin nyo, kinancel ko na exponent, eh. 16,000 newtons per coulomb. A positive 200 microcoulombs charge at the origin and the negative 300 microcoulomb charge is placed 1 meter to the right of it. What is the magnitude and direction of the electric field midway between two charges? 30 centimeters to the right of the negative charge. So, dalawa yung pinapahanap dyan. Una-muna yung, ano, yung electric field midway between two charges. Yung muna yung unang sasagutan natin. So, drawing natin class para, ano, may idea kayo. So, positive 200 microcoulombs is placed 1 meter to the 1 meter to the negative 300. So what is the magnitude and direction of the electric field midway between two charges? Tayo ng small positive test charge sa pagitan ni negative 300 tsaka ni positive 200 microcoulombs dito. So we have 0.5 meter and another 0.5 meters mula doon sa ating test charge. So dito, kukunin natin yung electric field na nararanasan doon sa pagitan ng dalawang charges, doon sa gitna. Okay, so una muna, 200 microcoulombs. We have electric field is equal to, so yung gagawin natin E sub 1 muna. E sub 1 is equal to K times Q sub 1 over R squared. We have 9 times 10 raised to 9 times 200 microcoulombs. That is 200 times 10 raised to negative 6 over distance between the test charge and point charge natin, we have 0.5 square. 7.2 or 7,200,000 or 7.2 times 10 raised to 6 newtons per coulomb. Doon naman sa E sub 2, at charge negative 300 microcoulombs. E sub 2 is equal to K, again, K times over R squared, in distance no charge 2, doon sa ating point charge, same lang naman yun na 0.5 meters. We have 9 times 10 raised to 9 times, punin nyo muna yung absolute value class ha, disregard nyo muna yung sign, 300 times 10 raised to negative 6, microcoulombs, that is 10 raised to negative 6, over 0.5 square. What is E sub 2? Electric field. Newtons per coulomb. So, titignan nyo na dito. Okay, so may direction to class ha. So, titignan nyo. Kung meron may positive test charge dito class, dito, may positive test charge tayo dito. So, repel siya, di ba? In direction ng E sub 1 natin ay papunta sa kanan. Positive charge, yung electric field niya ay pa magagaling sa kanya papunta sa infinity or pa outward. Samantalang yung negative charge natin ay galing sa infinity papunta sa kanya, yung electric field, or pa inward naman. Okay, tingnan niyo mabuti class yung electric field dito. Since repel siya class sa positive, papunta sa kanan. Okay, so yung magiging sign ng E sub 1 natin ay positive. Positive 7.2. Yung positive test charge naman class, yung positive test charge doon sa negative 300 microcoulombs natin. Attractive ba or repulsive? Attractive, okay? This one. Attractive. So, papunta din sa kanan. Since, alam nga natin, di ba, pa-inward yung direction ng electric field kapag negative. So, kung may small positive test charge tayo dito, sa gitna, so, attractive siya. So, yung direction ng electric field natin ay papunta sa kanan. Ito. Okay? So, positive din. Positive din yung 1.08 times 10 raised to 7. Ito ka, natandaan nyo lang ito. Ito. Pag positive, palabas. Negative, inward. Kaya titignan nyo dito, class. Yung sa, ano natin, yung sa Q sub 1 natin dito, yung sa charge 1, yung positive 200 microcoulombs dito. So, tingin, yung direction niya ay papunta sa kanan. O pa, outward. Okay? Or kung magbabase ka naman sa ganito na lang, kung ayaw mo naman sundin yung ganito, kung ayaw mo sundin yung ganito, ganito na lang, focus ka na lang dun sa point charge, as a test charge pala. Focus ka sa test charge. Since meron tayong positive test charge dito, okay, attractive ba siya o repulsive dito? Sa positive test charge natin, dun sa Q sub 1. Di ba repulsive siya? So, papunta yung electric fields niya sa kanan. Okay? So, magiging positive to. Doon naman sa E sub 2, kung meron tayong positive test charge dito, so attractive siya dun sa negative point charge, dito sa negative 300 microcoulombs. So, kanan. Okay? So, para yung positive, going to right. Ibig sabihin, class, dito, nung mga positive-negative na yan, so magiging sagot natin sa electric fields, meaning to say, yan yung kanilang direction. Okay? Yung electric field, midway between two charges, pag-a-add lang natin. That is E sub 1 plus E sub 2. We have E sub 1 plus E sub 2. We have 7.2. Parehong positive naman yung 7.2 times 10 raised to 6 plus 1.08 times 10 raised to 7. Yung electric field na naranasan or naranasan dito sa pagitan ng dalawang charges ay 1.8 times 10 raised to 7 newtons per coulomb. Then, yung isa naman, sagutin natin isa. Ito, gawin natin itong letter A. Ito si letter A. Yung B naman is 30 cm to the right of the negative charge. Ito yung positive. Ito yung negative. Positive 200 microcoulombs. And negative 300 microcoulombs. Then, we have distance between two charges, 1 meter. 30 cm to the right of the negative charge. So, 30 cm dito tayo. So, dito yung ating test charge. Okay? Dito yung ating test charge. Aalamin natin dito sa point na to, dito sa charge, sa location na to, yung electric field na naranasan. Okay? Yung electric field na naranasan dito, sa bandang dito, no? So, we have, 30 cm, no? So, dun sa negative 300 microcoulombs at saka dun sa ating test charge, may distance na 30 cm. So, alamin natin yung electric field na naranasan dito. So, muna yung positive 200 microcoulombs muna. So, we have electric field, yung E sub 1 is equal to K times Q sub 1 over R squared is equal to 9 times 10 raised to 9 times 200 microcoulombs or 200 times 10 raised to negative 6 coulombs. Convert natin sa coulombs muna ha. Over R squared. So, ano yung distance last dito? Ano yung magiging distance within dun sa positive 200 microcoulombs at test charge natin? We have 1 meter plus 30 cm. Okay, 0.3. Okay, so 1.3 square. 0.65. Okay, next, doon naman sa charge ng negative 300 microcoulombs. So, ilalet natin E sub 2 yun. Electric field between charge 2 and point charge. Test charge pala. It's equal to K times Q sub 2 over R squared. It's equal to 9 times 10 raised to 9 times 300. Ignore nyo muna yung sign plus. Kunin mo na yung absolute value. Times 10 raised to negative 6 over yung distance naman class between dun sa 300 tsaka dun sa test charge. We have 30 cm or 0.3 square. Kung napansin, closer. Ibig sabihin, the greater yung force. The greater yung force, the greater yung electric field na maranasan. Okay? Diyan sa bandang na yan na malapit sa isang sa charge 2. Pero nung kay charge 1, napakalayo na. 3 times 10 raised to 7 newtons per coulomb. Okay? So kung naglagay tayo ng test charge, positive test charge dito, sa bandang 30 cm sa kanan ni negative charge to natin o yung negative 300 microcoulombs. So, dito tayo nagbanda naglagay. Isipin nyo palagi ito class ito ay positive test charge. Okay? Para di kayo malito. Positive test charge. So, kung i-compare natin no, yung ano kayo magiging direction class ng electric field na maranasan natin dito galing kay positive 200 microcoulombs. Pakanan ba or pakaliwa? Okay. Pa-right. Okay? Kasi nga, ito yung tatandaan yung class, yung idea. Same sign, repel. Like sign, repel. Unlike sign, attracts. Okay? So, pareho yan, di ba? Tatandaan nyo ito. Ito ay positive test charge. Okay? Ay positive. Then, doon naman sa ating ano, sa charge 2, tsaka doon sa test charge, doon sa negative 300 microcoulombs, yung flow ng electric field, pa-left. Kasi, attracts siya, di ba? So, yung ating electric field na naranasan doon sa kanan ni negative 300 microcoulombs plus negative 3 times 10 raised to 7 newtons per coulomb. So, bakit negative plus? Tingin nyo, bakit negative? I-disregard na natin yung computation dito. Ha? Disregard nyo na yung computation. So, tingin nyo, bakit sa kaliwa yung direction ng ating electric field? The closer, the greater. Kung i-compare mo siya dun sa electric field dito, doon sa 200 microcoulombs is malayo na. Okay, malayo na compared dito, napakalapit. So, yung electric field ay mas malakas papunta sa kaliwa, yung direction. Depende kasi kung nasa nyo, ano, yung test charge. Okay?